Making sure it never happens again. That's the pledge of emergency managers following this past weekend's false report of a nuclear missile headed for Hawaii. Alex Demetric reports on what went wrong and the terror that followed.
The panic came within seconds of a cell phone alert Saturday in Hawaii.
A missile may impact on land or sea within minutes. This is not a drill.
The unthinkable threatening to come true.
Did he really do it? Did Kim really push that button? Did he really do it now?
The button that was pushed was in Hawaii's Emergency Management Agency. During a shift change while running a test, this message accidentally went out to hundreds of thousands of cell phones.
I accept responsibility for this. This is my team. We made a mistake.
To correct it, it will now take two people to activate the missile alert, because this is one mistake with its own unique fallout.
People were just in shock, and the beaches cleared in minutes.
Baltimore native Jenny Craig has lived in Hawaii for 5 years.
Oh my God, I gotta call my children. I have to call my mom back in Baltimore. I have to let everybody know that this may be the last time that I speak with them.
People were instructed to take shelter wherever possible. Very few at the indoor bomb shelter the Durkin family fled into.
Started throwing things down into the bomb shelter, and we closed the top, and then we got on our phones and looked for updates.
The first of those updates came 13 minutes later on Twitter, but it took 38 minutes for the Emergency Management Agency to send out an all clear. It was a long 38 minutes.
It really was.
A delay in procedure the agency says is now addressing to speed up. Alex Demetric, WJZ.
The Federal Communications Commission is also sending investigators to Hawaii to ensure safeguards are put in place to prevent another false alarm.